Deva, he becomes abrupt in his commentary. We are lost. The reason, because we have always been holding his hand, and not that he has shirked his hand. For a moment he is looking somewhere else, not looking towards us. That is how we feel, and that poses a tremendous amount of difficulty in understanding what the mantra has to say, why Gurudeva is saying what he is saying. But let us learn how even this terse explanation of Gurudeva has pregnant meanings. Sometimes, perhaps, this is just a guess, a wild guess rather, that what Gurudeva has in front of him as an audience, it's an imaginary audience while dictating the commentary. If for some misfortune of ours he thinks that the audience is highly elevated, he reduces the number of statements, depth of the explanation, and then we come into the trouble. Both are very deceptive mantras, apparently giving us a despair that nothing can happen. You are destined to do, so there is nothing that you have in your hand. So in one stroke, couple of very fundamental philosophical disputes it is bringing to the fore. One was rightly coined by Balaji, that is it predeterminism or will? It's been an old philosophical debate. Every religion, every darshan, every thought process has tried to answer it. Perhaps the best explanation and the answer has come from Hinduism, and why so is the time to study now. First aspect of the depth of these two mantras. Second aspect is both the mantras have one word in one expressly said, in another subtly said, but both the words are referring to what is called swabhava. So there is a concept of swabhava, there is a concept called swadharma, and then the interplay of these two in shaping a jiva in the stage that he is, and the expected course of action of a jiva towards his onward march to Paramatma. In order to understand this, first it would be better to look at the mantra's words. In the first mantra, entire 90% part of is a sequel, is effect. The cause is in the first word. Now the first word, when it says ahankaram ashritya, taking refuge into the ahankara. That means you took refuge in you. Ahankaram ashritya. That means Ishwaram tyaktva. You cannot have ashritata at two places. One is you have ashritata in yourself. You take refuge in yourself. Your ability which you pronounce that I have. Or else you surrender to the ability of someone else called Ishwara. Now, if I say that I am the sculptor of my destiny, which is actually a fact, I am the sculptor of my destiny, and if that is the so, then what is wrong if I take ashritya, refuge, in me? And if it is not wrong, then comes the question, na yotsa iti manyase, if you decide you will not fight, taking refuge in your this thing, mithya. Esha vyavasayaste. Vyavasaya here, vyavasayatmaka vruttihi buddhihi. Anything that does a resolve, vyavasaya is resolve. Aapka vyavasaya kya hai? We never resolve in what we do. But aapka vyavasaya kya hai? I do this. That means I have resolved to do that particular thing. There is no option left anymore. I have come to a conclusion. Nishchayatmaka vrutti buddhihi. I have made a nishchaya. Now the nishchaya is, I will not fight. Partha is a token example of a decision taken by an ego, by the greatest warrior ever born. We are very small fry warriors. The greatest warrior ever born has taken a decision, and his decision, the Lord says, is not right. So it requires some amount of analytical explanation also as to why it is so. And then he says that, prakruti stvam. Lord is not saying, I am not saying it. I have no business to do anything with you. ये युद्ध भी आपका है, ये युद्ध भूमि भी आपकी है. I have only one role to play. Supply the energy or the consciousness that is required. And I do not discriminate in that. चोर आता है, मैं बोलता हूँ ले जाओ चोरी करो, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. I have no problem. He uses intellect to do the stealing. Lord has absolutely no problem in it. And since he has no problem in it, he says that you reap, you sow, you reap the harvest. Once this is clear, then comes the question that when did I start the harvest? As a jiva, when did I come into existence? Anadi, I have no origin. Fair enough. One very common question that we ask is, यार पैदा ही नहीं करता हमको, गीता पढ़ने का भी कोई इशू नहीं है. If I was not born itself, what was the reason of reading this? And then the whole philosophy is thrown back into the purpose of creation of the universe and the variants of it. Here Aurobindo comes into the picture, is given beautiful commentary in these two mantras, and he says it is Lord's own presence in multiple forms constantly struggling and striving to reach the perfection. And this leela of perfection of a jiva going through the metamorphosis towards Paramatman is Lord's game that he enjoys. The question here is the instrument that are awarded to such a jiva, the instrument being of the type which has his own energy into it, ahankara being one of them. At the end, ahankara also is existing because of whom? Ahankara by itself, does it have an existence? Ahankara itself also takes a borrowed light from somewhere. So if Lord has distributed the instruments amongst the warriors, somebody decides to take the sword and kill himself. It is not Lord's intention to do that. Now the question is, why is it then I get a tendency to do that? Why a drunkard is a drunkard and I am not? I don't feel like drinking every day. There are people, they start their morning by the drinks. Why? And there are no exceptions to this. Most intelligent people do drink. So why is it that, and if you are trying to explain it to them, drinking is bad, he has already read the books, because all doctors have read the books and all of them drink with exception. The question here is, what is that is prompting me to do something? Now if I'm prompting, something is prompting me, that must be a propensity to do something. And a propensity comes from development of a tendency. Tendency comes from a repetitive procedure of a particular thing. We are now using tarka. If a repetitive tendency is there, that means I have done what I did just now before also. Else why should I do it? Do I sitting here think about what could be the speed of a space shuttle that is going? It is not my business, because it had not been my business. The word given by Kabir Maharaj is Preet Purani Karanere Chug Chuga Kankar Khai. A swan is supposed to eat the pearls, but now it is eating only the pebbles. That means somewhere he started eating the pebbles and it became a habit. A crystallized, oft-repeated habit is tendency. Deep-rooted tendency is vasana. So first thing is interaction, samskara. Jayate vishayan pumsa sangasteshu upajayate. First is contact. After the samskara, repetition of samskara. Repetition of samskara leads to development of roots for the samskara. When jada, root, becomes hardened, it converts into vasana. Or else, we could have come for only one Friday, job is done. It doesn't happen. One Friday, samskar. Sangasteshu upajayate. Gurudev ke saath sang ho jata hai. How much? Microsecond out of 2 hours. because still the mind is wavering here and there. This samskara again and again will propel you to do that. That is the reason only 40 people from Dubai have come here. The population is about 3.5 million. Why others do not come? Because others have not come earlier. Today, if I meet with Vasishtaji and Pradeepji, it is not a coincidence. He may not be in this Nama Rupa, but my interaction with them has been a part of the process. The feast has been going on in the past. The food is still being served, as they say. If this is the case, that means I am always born with what, how I can be defined. What would be my definition? What would be definition of my life? A very simple definition of life would be, my life is playing of an instrument. The instrument is played by Trigunas. The instrument is made up of Panchamahabhutas. It plays the swaras that are borrowed from Prarabdha. It plays it on the stage of a Maya, and it plays it in front of the audience of Veda. This is how the life itself is. Now, in Raga, if somebody knows a little bit of classical music, there is a Vadiswara and Samvadiswara, and Varjaswara and a Tivraswara. Now, if there is no ma in my Raga, Bhairav perhaps is being sung. Why ma is not there? Because ma has been left behind. It didn't come in this raga this time. And then there is a swara which shouldn't have been in that raga, but it has come. Anger. Because I brought it from the prarabdha. Now the question is, stage is set, audience is set, instrument is set, swaras are set. Question is, what melody will you play with the existing swaras? The art of playing the melody with provided swaras is in your hand. Neither the instrument is in your hand, nor the audience is in your hand, nor the stage in your hand, but the playing of melody is in your hand. And the sadhana is to play the best possible melody of the Lord in the given circumstances of the instruments. So what you get as paristhiti is your prarada swabhava janya. Swabhava is nature. Swadharma is action. Swadharma is seen. Swabhava is the subtle current on which swadharma is sitting. So swabhava sadharma in tango define a person. Uthta hai, subah 4 baje uth hi jata hai. And there is very, very personal experience of the kind. Certain saints are there about whom there is no need to read. Aa hi jata hai. Kitab kholi samajh hi jata hai. Kitab samajh mein aa rahi hai. Pata nahi log kahan kahan jate hain samajhne ke liye. Sanskrit apne aap aa raha, apne aap nahi aa raha hai. Kitab ka 46th page was left in the past. 47th is opened now. And this is going on. So there will be umpteen number of repetitions happening. The question here is, what is the gati? Gati as a word. Ananya prokta gatiratra nasti, Kathopanishad. We've seen the meaning of gati that time. Gati is, where do we go from where I am? Gantavya sthan is Lord. The question is, I may vibrate at the same level, don't neither go down nor go up. That is also possible. Also ran category. Or you move upwards. Then the question is, because I am born with certain nature, chhoti si baat hai, meri nature hi bhakti ki hai. Bhagwan ka naam lete hi aankh mein pani aa jata hai. So I have a propensity of bhakti in me. And then I decide that I shall not meditate on Lord Vishnu. You will not. You will have to. Bhakti will compare you. Naneshwar Maharaj says, Tava prakruti junzavel. You know, to the Lord, Naneshwar Maharaj says, there is no question of you saying yes or no. Your nature. The question now is, what kind of battle you will fight? Yes, that I will give to you. I will not fight. Fundamental question of fighting or not fighting is not in your hand. The manner of fighting is in your hand. And it is here that this so-called self-enfoldment, as Aurobindo calls it, is constantly towards expansion. To an extent, the misdirected energies of tamasikata also is an attempt by them, so that at a point of time they start moving again towards the urdhvagati. That being so, there is no jealousy or animosity in the Jivan Mukta's life. Otherwise, Swamiji could have said, all those people, half of them, you go, you're drinking, you're tamasi, you go. There will be no audience actually left. The question, because Swamiji used to say that if you're Trigunatita, there's no point in talking you and me. Unless you are in gunas, you can't be my audience. And then once Trigunas are invited, any gunas is welcome. It is just a progress. Instruments have not been properly tuned. Harmony is not coming. Lord is not happy. Ek bar instrument baith gaya. The setting has been properly done. Paanch tatva ka bana hai tamura. Tar laga nav ture ka. Ashtada prakruti and mana. Nav ture ka tar laga hai. Rachat tara marodat khunti nikasat raga huzureka. Every act and thought, kaya, mana, manasa and vak, if all the three are tuned in that way, understanding my nature, I'll give a very live example. I worked in a place where there were a lot of administrative powers. Being an IAS officer, you get a lot of powers. And powers means there is a difference between authority and power. So I had a lot of authority. I thought I have a lot of power. So a person sitting across the table naturally knew that power has to be appeased. When the appeasement happened in a different manner. Somebody brought a big shank from Odisha, saying that, sir, I knew you have a dharmic mind, so I brought this shank for you. I brought for you. It was the power that brought that shank. Now, the point here is, after taking that and putting it in front of the Lord also, happiness was not coming. Something has gone wrong in accepting this. After some time, it was realized that ye mera swabhav hi nahi hai. If I get into this more and more, apart darkness, there will be nothing in my life. Maybe there will be a flood of money. That means I was acting against my swabhava. So when somebody came and said, kya fayda hai yaar, nokri mil gayi, sab kuch ho gaya, abhi bhi pad rahe ho? Padhna swabhav hai. If I don't get a book, I don't feel happy. Why? Because ye mera swabhav hai. So let's go and do, you know, party in the evening. Wo swabhav nahi hai. It is not my nature. If I act against the nature, I shall not be reaping anything. And that is why the Lord says that you may go. It's not that we have done bad things in our life, but within no time you have come back to the place. Isliye everybody says, main bahut peeta tha. Ek time tha sahab, mere ko uthana padta tha. These are all stories. Padta tha kyun aata hai? पढ़ता हूं क्यों नहीं आता है? Because you are brought back. Because of your ahankar, or the so-called modern word for ahankar is peer pressure. You went with somebody, you did something, but ultimately you come. The samskar, every father has given better samskar to his child. Some of them remember it, saying that I don't eat non-veg. As a part of religious ethics, different story altogether. Swami Vivekananda used to eat it. It has got no significance that way. But man hi nahi karta hai. To see a non-vegetarian food on the table makes you feel something like nahi khana bhi nahi khana hai wahan pe. Why that thing is coming? Because khaya nahi hai. I have already been on a falahara for a long time. I shall like the fruits only. This is how Swabhava and Swadharma is playing. Once we know that how it is playing, then comes the question that the Mithya Esha Vyavasayaste. So do not make any Vyavasaya, any Nishchaya against your own Swabhava or Swadharma. So it presupposes something. And what it presupposes? Do you know your Swabhava? We never spend time in analyzing ourselves, because 99% we are analyzing others. When we analyze ourselves, we realize ki yaar nahi uthne ka tendency hai, laziness is there. That means tamasi pravritti ka swabhav bana hua hai. Agree. Now the question is, a poor man, when he is poor in his childhood, sometimes he doesn't have something to wear on the top because he is poor. Then he becomes an officer. Can he say that nahi pehle hum pehante nahi the? He starts wearing it. There is a change of status. Now this change of status, when it comes after understanding that I am of a tamasic nature, I can start reducing tamasikta. Inculcating rajasikta automatically comes, because when one is reduced, the other has to come up. And that is how we all talk to each other. पहले साहब मैं तो 8-8 बजे तक उठता ही नहीं था, अब थोड़ा सा फिर सोचा मैंने. सोचा means what? You acted upon it. Nature, अभी भी nature पुराना बीच बीच में ऊपर आता है. I'll give you a fine example of how nature predominates. In the year 1899, Swami Vivekananda was talking to his one of his Western disciples, and the question put by this lady who put the question was Dhira Mata, Ulibul. She put the question saying that, Swami, do you, for just for the question I am asking you, by any chance do you feel that you should have a family and a life and a wife and everything? Just as a curiosity I am asking you. And I was very keen to answer, to read the answer, because Jivan Mukta. Swamiji answered that yes. That was very shocking. He says, a trickle of a thought comes from somewhere from the corner, that you know, this world, life, wife, and before it reaches to me, it is thrown away. It does come, it is thrown away, but it comes means the tendency. Now this tendency of his must be of many yesterbirths. It is still coming in the form of seed. That is the reason why whenever we are trying to inculcate sattva guna, there are so many obstacles. And then to justify the obstacles, wife ne uthaya nahi, nahi to ud jata. Alarm baja nahi, alarm se uthna nahi hota hai. Yahan ka alarm bajna chahiye. Padhai waise nahi hoti hai. Gurudev is shouting from the rooftop, mananam, mananam, mananam. हम उसमें से म निकल देते न न न न न. Why is it so? It's because when I go back, I feel that Gita is not connected to me other than Friday. That thought is inculcated in the mind in a hardened manner. This again is because of what? Another thing. If you want to know what Swabhava is, why go anywhere else? Take the best possible example. What made him go straight from one end of India to the other end of India? Straight from here to that side. Swabhava Chatambi Swamigar, one of the most accomplished Hatha Yogi, used to come to Swamiji's house. Swamiji was that time infant, and he used to talk to him in infant language for half an hour. And all the household members of Gurudeva's family used to say, what are you talking? He said, shh, it is not between you and me, it is between him and me. Chatambi Swamigal used to speak to the animals, used to speak to dogs. A person came to meet him and he was surprised to see that he is wearing a black socks. He said, no, they are not socks, they are ants. So he went close and saw ants were covering his leg. So he said, ah, sir, I will. He said, they are resting. We have already spoken. They are resting here. To an extent that his own disciples, Kaupina, you know, the undergarment, was eaten by the rat. So he said, Swamiji, aapke yahan ke chuhe kha gaye bhai, अभी पहनने का प्रॉब्लम है, दोनों सन्यासी थे. चट्टंबी स्वामी सेड दिस शुड नॉट हैव हैपेंड, लेट मी फाइंड आउट विच रैट डिड इट, एंड आई एम नॉट गोइंग गिविंग अ स्टोरी, आई एम गिविंग अ फैक्ट. द डिसाइपल हैज डिस्क्राइब्ड इट, ऑल द रैट्स वेर कॉल्ड, द वन हु एक्चुअली इटन दैट रैट ऑल्सो केम फॉरवर्ड. Swamiji was speaking in Malayalam in his own language. That is how the disciple came to know, and he admonished him. This all sounds very strange. There is an absolute perfect example of how much he knew about the language of animals. One of the most corrupt police officers called Chattambi Swamigal for food in his house, just to show the people. He wanted to show his wealth, ill-gotten wealth, to Swamiji. People around were surprised. This man is so corrupt and he is calling. So Swamiji will say, no, I will not come. He said, I will come. I will have 15-20 members with me for food. He said, fair enough, no problem. I am the police officer. On the appointed day, he opened his door to welcome Swamiji. Swamiji was there with about 15-20 dogs. So Swamiji, dogs have come. He said, no, these are the guests. He said, Swamiji, he said, I told you 20 people will come, they have come. 20 places the plates were put. The dogs came like man, they sat on there. Only after Chattambi Swamigal said a mantram, then only they started eating, because they were all listening to him. After all this happened, the police officer came and said, sir, what is my mistake? What I got? He said, what you have earned, only these things can, these people can eat. What it indicates is he was a Hatha Yogi of highest caliber. He knew his swabhava at an infant. And that is how this infant became a giant. Swabhava will propel you. That is why first recognize. Sabse pehle. For a criminal to become a better man, what is the most important thing? To understand that he is a criminal now. Hamari problem kya hai? Ki I am a papi. We don't agree with that. Because wife says dharma ka kaam karte hai. ब्रदर से दैट बहुत धार्मिक है. माँ से इसकी ये तो हमेशा जब भी आता है मंदिर में चला जाता है. ईच अदर, एवरीबॉडी इज डिसीविंग, चीटिंग ईच अदर. मैं कहाँ पे हूँ? वेयर आई एम. गीता इज ट्राइंग टू से दिस टू मंत्रास, फाइंड आउट वेयर यू आर. फाइंडिंग आउट वेयर यू आर इज स्वभाव एंड स्वधर्म. द रीजन वाई स्वभाव स्वधर्म, यू आर इन अ कैवेलरी, हाउ कैन यू गो इन इन्फेंट्री? Because cavalry man coming in infantry, immediately he'll be killed. If you're a fighter pilot, now you want to run a tank. If these things in vyavhar cannot be there, jisko hum log management mein aptitude bolte hain. This is what aptitude is. Aptitude in swabhava and swadharma. So once I know what type of, even minute analysis can also tell us whether I am a jnana prone or karma pradhana prakruti hai. कि ज्ञान प्रधान प्रकृति है, त्याग प्रधान प्रकृति है कि भोग प्रधान प्रकृति है. वंस वी नो दैट, देन यू कैन टेक डिफरेंट स्टेप्स इनटू इट. दैट इज व्हाई टू नो द परिस्थिति, टू अटेन द स्वस्थिति बाय अचीविंग उपस्थिति, यू मस्ट बी अलर्ट अबाउट योर नेचर. एंड दैट इज व्हाई स्वामी सेज the temperament must seek its expression. Ek jivan mukt the Swami Nisargadatta Maharaj. I Am That is a book which is bestseller on Amazon of his. A jnani of a very high order. The book is full of jnana. He was a bidi seller. And all the Americans and Europeans used to come and meet him there. He had a small bidi shop in Bombay. He himself used to smoke bidi. One Gora came and asked, Swamiji, this is, where is Jnanam, where is Bidi? How can you reconcile it? He said, Sharir ko kuch yaad hai, kuch adate lag gayi. This is a swabhav of my Sharira. But he had that authority to say, because he said, I am not Sharira. There was no Dehat Adatma. He said, there are some habits. Imagine, even for Jivan Mukta, take Swamiji's example, didn't leave Papadam till end. It was not advised that he should be eating it. But he said, le gaya, wo marna varna baad mein dekha jayega. Why? That time, won't we say that how can a jivan mukta? It was not a question of jivan mukta, because it is ingrained in swabhava of that sharira. तभी तो आपको किसी को चॉकलेट अच्छा लगता है किसी को नहीं लगता है. सम पीपल डाई फॉर चॉकलेट, सम पीपल हेट इट. दैट हेट्रेड केम फ्रॉम वेयर? इट इज, दैट इज हाउ. देन फर्दर स्वामी सेज इट इज अ लॉ ऑफ नेचर दैट हिज मेंटल टेम्परामेंट वुड assert itself at a later period when, alas, he may not have had held the field to express himself, to exhaust his vasanas. Dono cheeze hai, to know the nature, to know the nature so that you can control the nature, to control the nature, till the time you control the nature you exhaust the vasanas, because controlling nature is exhausting the vasanas. And that is why when it comes to control, the word vasha has come. The next mantra, if you see the word here, is avasha. There are three words we have in Sanskrit: avasha, vivasha, parivasha. Hum log vivasha hai. Gurudev bolte parivasha ho jao. Tum parivash ho ya vivash ho? Parivasha, to depend on somebody else. Pari means around. Maybe a person or a situation. विवश विशेषेण हेल्पलेसली हेल्पलेस. एंड देन दैट इज द रीजन यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड द वर्ड ओवर द डैम्सेल ऑफ गॉड्स उर्वशी. उर हार्ट, वश वन हु कंट्रोल समबडी एल्सेस हार्ट इज उर्वशी. दैट इज हाउ दैट वर्ड उर्वशी हैज कम. नाउ द क्वेश्चन हियर इज, दिस मंत्र सेज अ स्वभाव जैन कौंतेय निबद्ध स्वेन कर्म. निबद्ध, नॉट ओनली बद्ध. संस्कृत इज सच अ ब्यूटिफुल लैंग्वेज. निश्चयेन बद्ध, बिकॉज ऑफ युअर स्वभाव युअर कर्म इज इंट्रिकेट इनएक्सप्लिकेबली इंटरवोवन. निबद्ध विथ युअर कर्म. सो इफ दैट इज द केस, कर्तृम न इच्छसी. इन केस you declare kartrum na ichhasi, why? Mohat. That mohat is also ahankar. The word there is ahankara, word here is mohat. Word there is prakruti, word there used is prakruti, which is again swabhava, word here is swabhava. Yan mohat karishyasi avasha api tat, you shall have. The question here is, what has happened is, jisko hum log smashan vairagya bolte hain. Some guy passes away, we go in the funeral, everybody decides, कुछ नहीं है जिंदगी में, क्या देखिए एक दिन जाना ही है. By the time you come back, the funeral is over. Now what happened at that point of time is what the Lord is trying to say, that don't do. Why? Change will come in a stage-wise manner. तुका मने तेते नाही चालत तातडी प्राप्त काळ घडी आल्या विना. धीरे 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 रे मना, धीरे सब कुछ होए. माली सींचे सौ घड़ा, ऋतु आए फल होए. यू मे वॉटर इट एवरी डे, यू विल हैव टू वेट फॉर द सीजन टू गेट द फ्लावर. सो व्हेन स्वभाव एंड प्रकृति इज नोन, टू थिंग्स शुड बी नोन. माय स्वभाव हैज बिकम द स्वभाव ओवर नंबर ऑफ बर्थ्स. सो फॉर मी टू मूव फॉरवर्ड बैक टू माई स्वस्थिति और परमात्मन, एक्सपेक्टिंग इट, दैट इज द रीजन. इधर कृष्ण भगवान दिखे नहीं, इन्होंने बोल दिया खत्म, हम संन्यास लेंगे. कृष्ण सेड नो नो नो, डोंट लुक एट मी, इट डजंट गो दैट वे माय डियर. फर्स्ट यू फिनिश व्हाट यू आर डूइंग. ये जो रजोगुण है ना, भगिनी निवेदिता का नाम एवरीबडी हैज लर्न्ड. भगिनी निवेदिता व्हेन शी केम टू स्वामी विवेकानंद, शी वॉज ऑलवेज इंसिस्टिंग फॉर संन्यास, ऑफिशियल संन्यास. स्वामी जी डिडंट गिव संन्यास. You know what he said? Nivedita, you are a Kshatriya. Fighting is in your blood. Go and serve the people. Fight with the odds and circumstances. Why? Rajoguna Prabalyam. Sattvaguna Pradhanyat Sanyastaha. Swamiji ko sanyas kyun mila? Sattvaguna Pradhanya was there. Tapovan Maharaj. Rajogun ki puja bhi nahi karte the. Khat nahi likhte the. Writing a letter to a devotee wouldn't bring me back into karma. नहीं चाहिए. इट डिपेंड्स. शिवानंद महाराज भी गुरु है, तपोवन महाराज भी गुरु है, दोनों के स्वभाव में कितना फर्क है देखिए. अगर जीवन मुक्त के आयु में इतना फर्क है तो हम तो बद्ध लोग हैं, निबद्ध लोग हैं. एंड दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई इट सेज दैट इफ एट ऑल यू वांट टू गो दैट वे, देन यन मोहात डिल्यूड, यू आर डिल्यूडेड. डिल्यूजन क्या है आपकी? डिल्यूजन ये है कि करता मैं. सो व्हेन यू एक्ट बिकॉज ऑफ प्रोपेंसिटीज. प्रोपेंसिटीज विल फोर्स यू टू डू समथिंग बिकॉज दे आर प्रोपेंसिटीज. वासना का प्रेशर है. बहुत कुछ पढ़ा हमने, स्वामी विवेकानंद पढ़ा, ये पढ़ा, ब्रह्मचर्य पढ़ा, और उतने में थोड़ी खूबसूरत दिखने वाली, वो पूरा जितना पढ़ा था वो सब पानी हो जाता है. क्यों? प्रोपेंसिटी. विश्वामित्र नहीं कुछ कर सके. सो डज दैट मीन दैट फायदा ही नहीं है? दैट इज नॉट द स्टोरी. व्हेन महाराज वाज आस्क्ड अबाउट द सेम मंत्रा, ही सेड एन अल्कोहलिक शुड नॉट कम एंड से क्या करूं, मेरा तो प्रोपेंसिटी है, रात को बैठना ही पड़ता है. दैट इज नॉट द मीनिंग. द मीनिंग इज यू आर इंक्लाइंड फॉर दैट. नाउ यू फाइंड हाउ यू कैन बेटर इट, एंड व्हाइल बेटरिंग इट ऑल्सो कीप इट इन योर माइंड. आज छोड़ा कल निकल गया, विल नॉट हैपन. कीप कमिंग टू द क्लास, कीप थिंकिंग अबाउट गीता. अ डे विल कम, एवरी डे. दैट इज व्हाई दे से अध्यात्म का बीज अगर पत्थर पे भी गिरे तो उसमें से पौधा निकल ही आता है. व्हाई डू यू थिंक वी ऑलवेज गो टू द सेंटली पीपल, उनकी धूल लगाते हैं? व्हाई डू वी डू दैट? व्हेन यू गो टू स्वामी अय्यप्पम, व्हाई डू यू गो दैट? नेवर से दैट क्या वहां पे जाके मिलता है. नो, बाय द फैक्ट दैट वहां तक पहुंचने में, सबरीमला पहुंचने में 99% ऑफ टाइम इज ऑन सांसारिक गोष्ट. डजंट मैटर फॉर 0.1% ऑल्सो ही थिंक्स ऑफ स्वामी शरण अय्यप्पम, इट्स मोर देन इनफ. क्यों? वन इंच फॉरवर्ड. And that is one of the reason why Swamiji specifically talks about the actions we do are propelled by our own vasanas. Nature will assert itself. He who has no control over his mind become a victim of circumstances. Now Swamiji suddenly has gone towards control. The second half of second mantra, why he has gone for control is because knowing diagnosis, doctor ne diagnosis kiya aur patient ko bola jao ghar jao, he will beat him. Diagnosis is not important. Where is the treatment? So swabhava is a diagnosis. Swadharma is a signs and symptoms. Swabhava rog hai. Swadharma uske signs and symptoms hai. Once you know this, then the treatment has to start. And treatment, Swamiji says, is only one. Dawa ek hi hai. Control of the mind. And mind's control itself means diminishing the ahankara. Is the control of mind. Diminishing करने के लिए क्या करना होता है? Ego. We don't know how deep rooted our ego is. We normally feel that I am very humble person. बहुत मेरे पास अभी कुछ खास बचा नहीं, थोड़ा एक दो इंच कुछ ईगो बचा होगा. It's not so. It is so सुप्त inside. There was a swami called Gadgi Maharaj in Maharashtra. Another Jivan Mukta. You know this watermelon. Scooped watermelon was his hat, thrown somewhere. All his life he did only one thing. He had a broom in his hand. Whichever place, village he will go, he will not ask anybody. He will start cleaning the village. All the fecal matter, dirt, everything he is to clean. If somebody gave something, fine. And the jute sack that was thrown somewhere was his tunic. On his own, he built more than 250 dharmashalas. He continued to stay on the banks of river where whatever was there. He never stayed in his own dharmashala also, because he used to say, this is, people have given money for that. This is, no, Lord has told me to stay like this. He wanted to kill his ego during his Parivrajaka days. What he did was, he went for begging alms. While begging alms, he suddenly felt that I am becoming a sannyasi now. I am getting some good control on my mind. And he realized that I have got good control of mind is an ego. So to kill that ego, that day was a Gudi Padwa day where you make Puran Poli in Maharashtra. So he went to one place and said that he begged. So that lady came and gave him some roti. He said, no, no, give me no Puran Poli. She was shocked. He said, beggar, you are asking for Puran Poli? She called her husband. So he said, why? Are you mad or what? No, 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 you are eating. Give it to me now. The man came out with a very long bamboo stick and started beating him. He was continuously beating him. He said, nahi, aadha to de do na. He kept on beating him. After the beating, he started bleeding from his back. After that, he went, even that roti was also not given to him. He went and sat near a tree. One man came and said, Baba, इतना मार रहे थे, क्यों, व्हाई यू आर आस्किंग फॉर पोलियो एंड ऑल दैट, ही सेड यू डोंट नो व्हाट आई हैव गॉट. अब थोड़ा कम हो गया, नाउ द ईगो हैज गॉन डाउन अ बिट. दिस इज हाउ यू फाइट एन ईगो, ह्यूमिलिटी टू एन एक्सटेंट. हु कैन बी हम्बल, ओनली द लॉर्ड सर्वेंट कैन बी हम्बल. जिनको होना चाहिए वो होते नहीं है, जो राजा बन सकते हैं वो बनते नहीं है. दैट इज द कॉन्ट्रास्ट दैट वी आर फेसिंग, एंड दैट इज वाई नोइंग स्वभाव, नोइंग स्वधर्म, एक्टिंग अपॉन इट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो प्री डिटर्मिनिज्म वर्सेज फ्री विल इज अ ओल्ड डिबेट, एंड द ट्रूथ लाइज इन बिटवीन, नॉट ऑन द एक्सट्रीम्स. नथिंग इज प्री डिटर्मिंड, अदरवाइज वाई डिड यू कम टू दुबई? Sheikh Mohammed will call you if that is there in your. Why didn't you do that? Even the people who say that there is nothing, everything is destined, ask him, why are you speaking this? So, to sab hona tha, and in, this is one of the most commonest escape route taken by Indians, especially. मैं बहुत कोशिश कर रहा हूँ गीता समझ में. Ultimately, उसके कुछ हाथ में नहीं है. The will to work is given to you, but you will not have knowledge of English to read Swamiji. That is predeterminism. पढ़ा ही नहीं, स्कूल गया ही नहीं, स्वामी जी का ये पढ़ने नहीं आएगा, ये predeterminism है. लेकिन पढ़ने नहीं आता है तो मैं सुनने के लिए चला जाऊंगा, एटलीस्ट आई कैन लिसन बिकॉज दिस पीपल आर स्पीकिंग, उसमें कुछ तो कान पे आएगा. दिस इज फ्री विल. सो प्री डिटर्मिनिज्म एंड फ्री विल गो हैंड इन हैंड. टिल द टाइम यू एस्केप द प्री डिटर्मिनिज्म and become free will by itself. Free will by itself and will or desire mein farak hai. One who has predeterminism desires, one who is completely with free will, there is no desire. That is one of the reason why Lord has no desire in making the world. Understanding that takes a lot of time. So two mantras, though short, have enormous metaphysics packed into it, and on these two alone it is possible to go across the river of samsara. Hari.